And we're going to name this one Pants. A couple reasons for that. One is because she wears the pants in the family between her and Boots. And the other one is because Boots and Pants and Boots and Pants and Boots and Pants and Boots and Pants.
Maisie on Blaze Games.
Hey there, everybody. Maisie on reporting for duty. And today we're going to do a bunch of things. We're going to fill up the dino garage with a couple of dinos. I'm not really sure which ones we're going to get. I did see a 116 Ankylo really close. So that's something I'm going to look at right now. I'm going to go see if we can pick it up and drop it in the taming bin. But making a bunch of narcotics today because I knew that I needed it. I also needed to make a bunch more bullets so that we can make sure that we have enough trank darts and whatnot for what we need to do. Did I pick up all of the... I did. There it is. Oh, there's the extra. So we're going to stake this stuff. We're going to stick it right in here because we know that we're going to need to make some more trank darts. But for now, we've got the 65. That probably is enough to take down a 116 Anki. And it should be right outside the gate over here. I was over there getting some prime because I just tamed a level 100 Dimorphodon just a second ago. Is this the 116 Anki? Please be this awesome Anki. Oh, yep. That's it. Perfect. Pick it up. What's up, Anki? I am going to tame thee. Make thee my friend. Level 116, pretty high. Gonna be great for the oil field. That's what we're gonna use it for. Right over here, we're gonna go through and get oil with it. So, I'm gonna bring it over to the taming box. Because that'll be the easiest place to tame it. Even though it'll be very, very cold. Oh, the sun's rising. That means it's gamma downtime. And we can watch the sun rise. Rises pretty fast around here. Look at the color change there. Nice. Now we're getting into some pinks. All right. Where is my box? There's my box. You're freezing and you should seek warmth immediately. Now, the one thing I don't know is what kind of food I'm going to feed to this guy. We're either going to go get some advanced crops from Poop City or we're going to feed it some kibble. I can't remember what it requires. We're going to look it up before we make any decisions. We've got 65 trank darts. We've got an Anki in a box and we're going to shoot it in the face. I love this taming box. Super effective. And so, as you guys know, it's about 5 seconds for maximum torpor, and that's great with this gun because it takes about 4 seconds to reload it. Right. I feel like Soul on Fire was getting attacked, but I guess not. Anyway, it's probably going to take a few darts. I'm going to actually count them as we go. We've already hit it with 5. And we're going to be back with you once this thing falls down. Alright, so it took 12 darts to take it down. Not very much. Have a look at this guy real quick. See how much torpor he's got. Plenty of torpor. We're going to stick this on here. And now we're going to go have to grab... You know, I didn't ever look up what kind of kibble it needed. So I'm going to have a look real quick. We're going to see if we're going to feed this guy advanced crops or any kibble at all. It's a girl, actually. My bad. Alright, we've got our 3 kibble. It's all done. Ready to go. Not going to waste this citronal. We're going to go put it in the fridge. Kibble stuff. Alright. And we do need to... I've got jerky in there, too. We do need to make a preserving bin. It's time for us to make our own jerky. And I've also considered today that it might be time to make my own garden. I let the crops die over at Poop City. And that's unfortunate. Wanted rock carrot seed. I'll probably need that later. But we've also got some advanced crops here. Some long grass that we're going to use to tame the Anki. The Anki's still over at the taming bin. Safe and sound. And we've got no meat on Soul on Fire. I'm going to have to do a meat run today too. Looks like we're getting low on a bunch of stuff. But. Say lovey. So we're going to go over back to the taming bin. We're going to stick this stuff on the Anki and see how much the 3 kibble that we do have will raise the effectiveness. And since we have 3 in a stack and we've got a bunch of long grass in a stack, we're not worried at all about losing any of that effectiveness. We're just going to put those stacks right on it and see how that goes. I've got some trank on it and I've been coming back and making sure that I continue to put... Why did I do that? Coming back and making sure that I continue to put it on him to make sure that he's still out. So I'm going to put the kibble on, put that on, watch his taming effectiveness go up. 1, 2, 3 kibble eatings. Now it's eating the advanced crops. Much, much slower. We might have to ask around and see if anybody's got any Dilo eggs. Because I really would like to get this processed over with sooner rather than later. But for now, this is going to have to do. When we get closer to getting this girl up, we'll be back with you. Alright, so I'm just coming back from checking on the Ankies. And I got a couple of Stegos down here. And one of them's level 8, so that's great. Won't take very much to take that one down. Oh, why am I checking your inventory? I want to make sure it's on passive. And so it's going to be easy to take down the 8. Hopefully it's this one. Yes, it is. So what we're going to do right now real quick is not shoot it in the face with the wrong gun. And in order to make sure that that never happens, we're going to switch guns. There we go. And then we're going to take down that one. I want to do this as soon as possible so that I can move on and do some other things while these guys are taming up. Or this guy and this girl. But this side of my base is relatively safe. Stuff barely ever spawns here. So I'm not really worried about them as they're... Oh, she's already down. 2 darts to take this one down. And I grabbed some advanced crops to put on there. So each one of these will have a bunch of advanced crops on them. And I got Poop City rerunning, so it's got all the things that it needs. Bam! What's up, Stego guy? I think you're going to take a little bit more than 2 darts to go down, aren't you? See if we can get these down in relatively the same area. But this one's 72, so it's going to be a little bit more of a challenge than the level 8. Woo! I love this part of my base. I'm glad that I left it. Oh no, I didn't run away before and I got hit. I'm glad that I left it sectioned off. I think I'm going to stick some more Ankies in here. I'm going to grab a couple of pig moles to put on top of my base for the birds to be tethered to. Whoa! That was some strange laggish things. We could just... Oh no! We could just corral it around that other one. You've got a lot of darts in your face, Mr. Stego. Are you down? Oh, they're close enough. Uh-oh. Oh, there's something eating. I thought I heard something being attacked, but it was that eating. So now we've got 97 on this. See how she's doing. Advanced crops. Still going to take quite a while. We're going to need to have some narcotic on each of these. We're going to have to keep coming back to check them. But right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go recheck the Anki, see what its status is at. And then I'm going to start making the stuff for a farm because I need my own farm here. I'm not exactly sure where I'm going to put it. I almost want to put it over here on this side. We're going to see how the groundwater is. The water is a little bit lower, a little bit higher, lower, higher on this side. So we're going to try to do it on the other side, I think. But we're going to pick a good spot, which is going to be a pain. And we got back to the Ankie just in time for it to get up. And we're going to name this one Pants. A couple reasons for that. One is because she wears the pants in the family between her and Boots. And the other one is because Boots and Pants and Boots and Pants and Boots and Pants and Boots and Pants. Right? Alright, so we've got a saddle already made. We had the best saddle at the Hoop City was the Apprentice Ankylo saddle. So we've got that thing already. We're going to move it out of the bin because whenever you pick up something with a Quetzalcoatl or any other animal... and you drag it against walls, you drop it. So, we're going to have to get it out in the open here so that we can grab it up with a Quetzal. It's cold. And so there's one other dino that we need today. And that is a big, big pig mole to do all of the pooping for the new garden. I've already started to make the stuff for the new garden. And I've already decided the location of the new garden. I'm going to demolish that first shack that I made when I moved out here. And I'm going to make the new garden near this little lake on the other side of the wall here. And that's because we'll be able to use that lake in order to get water if we can't get water right out of the ground. It's going to be perfect. It's going to be amazing. And we're going to bring over and we're going to test out the efficacy of the... Stop following me. Of Pants today on the oil as well as in comparison to the pick. So we got a lot of things going on today now. It became a busy day. I'm going to check on this level 8 Stego. It's going to take a really long time to tame up this level 72. This level 8, not so much. I haven't actually had to use any narcotic on either of these so far. But they're going to be sitting here doing this for a while. So now, I'm going to have a look real quick over here. So what I'm gonna have to do, I think actually I was going to replace this, but what I'm gonna have to do instead, I think, is make it kind of like right here, and then we can pipe water up from this area over to that area. I don't think anything over here is a flatter, better area for that than this area right here. So I'm gonna have to demolish all of this stuff. Plus, I've got a bunch of junk. Oh, look, that's an actual helmet of some sort. Ramshackle trike bone helmet. Armor 80. Maybe it's just a regular flak helmet. I don't know. Oh, we've got blueprints in here and a bunch of junk. Oh, moving on. More junk. More junk. Nothing. Nothing. So these are going to be the easy ones. This will also give me a bunch of wood to build the new stuff with. So we don't need roofs and all kinds of things. I'm going to demolish this off cam. And we'll be back with you. We've got more exciting things going on. And one of our stegos is up. We're going to name this stego. I don't know. What are we going to name it? We're going to name it at a different time. It's up. Its name's Maz. All right. So we're going to check this out. I got to think of a name for this pair. We'll give this one some torpor management. We're going to have to build saddles for these two as well so we can get them easily in and out of the garage. So they're going to take this off of you and probably these advanced crops. And you can starve. You can starve for the time being. Also, don't follow me. I don't want you to follow me. So that's our female. It's up and ready to go. And now we got to go find a pig mole. I've already started the platform over here. As you can see, it's a lot bigger. I think what I'm going to do is right here, I'm going to make a row of compost bins. Lots and lots of compost bins. And then over here, I'm going to extend this a little farther and we're going to make some crop plots. And so you can go up in here, do all your compost binning stuff and maybe some chests down at the end. And then we're going to have our crop plots right here. I think I'm going to do some like on one side and some on the other so we can walk in there real easy. But I also need some more foundations. We're going to have to go out on our mammoth, get some wood, make some more foundations, make some storage. We've already got all the compost bins, so we're ready to do that part of it. But right now, I need something that'll poop. I need something that'll poop a lot. So we're looking for a pig mole on the beach. We got to find a pig mole somewhere. They like to hang out in beachy areas. That's where it's the easiest to find them anyway. But I'm not seeing any right now, so I'm going to have to search around for a little bit and return. So one out. So I went out and I grabbed a level 44 pig mole female thing. I didn't want to go too high because I didn't want it to take too long, and I didn't want to go too low because I wanted it to have some weight to start. So put her on passive, start shooting this in the face, and it's trapped within my area, so it can't go very far. It's kind of like a hunting area. Oh, it's already down. Well, that was really difficult. We'll put these raw carrots on there. Put some of that on there just in case. And so that'll start taming up as we hang out and do other things. I'm going to check on our stego. Stego's doing all right. Doesn't need any torpor management. And now we've got to go get on my mammoth. We need some more wood so we can make some more foundations and stuff. So we got mammon here ready to do work. Man, I've got these all over the place. And I'm going to start being choosy about their levels. I think 70s. Two is a little bit low. I want to get some high level ones so we can make a really high level team that will be able to take out alphas. And a Slipgator was just saying to me today that he got one of his Dimorphodons up to like 2,000 health and 1,000 damage. And I think that's going to be kind of what we're shooting for as we move forward. Now, I was also thinking that when we have a ton of them, you might not need their damage to go up, but they're so slow. So I think I'm going to make one that has a lot of health and damage, and then I'm going to make a bunch that have a lot of health and speed. The one that I have health and damage with, I think will be kind of a companion, and the rest will just kind of do work. Go kill things like alphas and other things that are gigantor. But I got to make a bunch of foundations. I got to make a bunch of pipes for the water to be able to reach. Brain, do work, brain. For the water to be able to reach the crop plots. So we got to do all that right now. Our Fiomia is up and we're going to name it right now. Whoop. Poop Blaster. It's the Poop Blaster. I'd like a saddle for it, but we're not that worried. But I've made the structure over here for what we want. For the crop plots and everything. It might be a little bigger than I need, but it's big enough to be happy. And we probably can get Poop Blaster up on here somewhere too. But we're going to go ahead and start to build stuff to find out. Now, did I grab all of the things off of Soul on Fire? Did not grab all of the things. I need the rest of the things. Give me the things, please. I need you. Yep, and you. And am I too heavy? I'm almost too heavy. But what we'll do to counteract that problem is start to do our boxes right now, our compost bins. I'm going to make them all in a nice, neat line along the side of this thing. All right, so something. Being very careful because I'm catering to my OCD. Something like that. And in order to do the rest of these straight, we're just going to keep going down the line. I'm going to have 20 of these boxes, and the reason is because I had 9 over at Poop City, and it's really not enough. I'd like to do bulk poop. You know, I'm not even counting. I only want 10 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We got 2 more on this side. I'm going to reline the stuff up. That's pretty close. That's pretty close. All right. 2 more. 1. And then a 2. So we've got 10 on that side. We're going to do 10 on this side as well. Line it up good and straight. So we'll be able to make 40 fertilizer at a time. So Poop Blaster is literally going to be blasting out massive amounts of poops all the time. We're going to need to get plenty of stem berries for him, plenty of food to make sure that we keep up his food while we're feeding him stem berries. We almost done? I bet you they're not going to line up good, because on the second one I wasn't as worried with the second layer as I was with the first one. But they're close enough. So now we've got a line of compost bins. Perfect. And we're going to be very careful with the crop plots. Now what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to try to put some crop plots on the left and some on the right. So we're going to use this one row. Is this 3 wide, right? Yep, 3. So we're going to put one on this side and one on the other side. And we're going to leave ourselves a walking space in the middle. Now, to get these perfect, right? Yep, not facing the right direction. Now a little bit too much the other way. How do we get you perfect? That's pretty close. That's pretty close to perfect. I can't see the lines. All right, now I can, right there. Bam! 1. I didn't say you'd get out of the K menu. You don't listen. You do what you're told. 2. And then we'll do a 3rd. 3. And on the other side, we'll do the same thing. Close to the middle. 1. 2. And so we're going to hope that if we do the irrigation right down the center, that it reaches all of these things. So there's that one side, there's that other. I got some other stuff that I need to put up here too. I got 4 of these. And so we're going to put these right here. I'm not going to be too worried about how they look. But we're going to put them kind of in the corner here. We can just reach them all. They don't need to be set up like everything else. But this is a good little crop area. I like it. The gamma's jacked up. There we go. All right, so now I got to figure out what I want to do here. So we're either going to work the pipes on the deck like this down to the water, or we're going to do it the opposite way and try to bring them up. Now, we need it to be right in the center to reach all the crop plots, and I'm worried that it might not reach them all. So what are we going to do here? Actually, what I'm going to do first, where? Vertical pipes. There's a vertical pipe. We can do it like this too. That should be able to work. We should be able to... Whoa. That still goes way down. Let me see. It might not work. I can't see the pipe. Is it working? We're going to keep on hoping that it's doing what we think it's doing. Is it doing what I think it's doing? I don't know, man. It's in the ground. I never have been able to hide these in the ground before. I feel like we're just tapping on the same one over and over again now. Yeah, I don't know if that's going to work the way I want it to work. I just wasted a bunch of pipe. It's up here! Oh, wow! That'll work too. That'll work too. All right, so we've got a bunch of pipe up in the air. And then, so we're going to hope that when we do the tap, which, wow, it's going to have to be right there. We're going to hope that everything works out the way we want it to. All right, so let's put the tap on there. So we've got a tap. Please reach all the crop plots. I thought they were going into the ground. They were going above my head. I wasn't even paying enough attention to figure that out. All right, so what if we put a straight pipe on this thing now? How far down does it go? Not far enough. All right, so what we got to do is we got to put another straight pipe on the side here. Another straight pipe. And now we need an incline. I think. Too far down? Is it going into the ground? I can't tell. I cannot tell if that's going into the ground. So what we're going to do is we're going to put one more. To be safe. One more straight pipe. Now an incline. And now a tap. I hope. Uh-oh. No. So we're going to have to keep going out. Man, good thing I made more inclines. So this didn't work out exactly like I wanted to, but it's still going to work as long as... we come out into the deep part of this here. Is this as deep as it gets? I guess it gets a little deeper over here. One more. All right. Cross your fingers. I think we're good. Tap. Yay. We have water. Is there water? Yay, there's water. Are we irrigated? Irrigated. Everything's irrigated. Perfect. It's a long pipe, but we've got all the irrigation set up now. So now we can just blast poop out of poop blaster, make a ton of fertilizer, and we can make crop plots. Now, I only need four, really, but I left two extras in case of expansion, in case they make other things that you can't harvest that you would need. So let's go check on our stego real quick. Checking on our stego. Still doing good. It's only got 9 advanced crops left. Let's find our Fiomia. Here we go. Bam. Fiomia's got nothing on it. Where did I put all those advanced crop plots? Advanced crops. I do not know where the advanced crops are. I don't think I have any on her. I don't remember where I put them. We're going to have to go get some medjool berries. And then what we're going to do is we're going to go over and test out the Anki. All right, so we're leaving the base with Bella and Lightning, my guard dogs, coming out to take care of me, make sure that I'm safe. And I'm not really sure how effective it's going to be. There you go. Kill that stuff. Eat it. Wow, this Anki can take care of business by itself. We need to find... Come on, Bella and Lightning. Do your job. Thank you. They're amazing guard dogs. Look at them go. Just destroy everything. Thank you so much, Bella and Lightning. So we're going to go over here to this one right here. Going to grab up a bunch of oil from it. Where's there another one? There's a couple over there. They're kind of spread out around here, you see. I'm not sure what's going to be the best plan. Might have to drop it over here with the Quetzal or on that shore over there. Let's go. 48 oil. Killed it with one swipe. Ankies swim pretty fast. We'll just keep it in the water. Swim right over to this other one. We're going to do this other one with our pick. So we got 48 oil with one swipe on this Anki. We'll do this one with the pick. The next one we'll do with the Anki again. And then the final one we'll do with the pick. And there's four over in this area. We might have to get a Quetzal out here to really do some accurate testing. But this will be close enough. We got our pick now. 12, 23, 31, 34, 41. So that wasn't much difference. Got a Packy over here. What's up, Packy? Kind of cold out here for you, pal. Be careful. So we're going to go over here to this one. We're going to use the Anki again. See if we get more than 48. It's so slow going. I almost want to jack the speed up on this guy. So that time we only got 37 on the Anki. Right? Yep. 37. So that was less than we got with our pick. Must find another. Wait, is that one right there? Did I just pass one? Why did I do that? Well, that was weird. We're going to run over to this one. We'll use the pick on this one. Because I heard that Ankies get a lot more. But so far, not so much. Might be the size of them, too. 48 on the pick. All right. Whoa. Come on, my dogs. Do work. Gonna kill this thing? I'll just kill it with the Anki. Oh, there's one more over there. So, final test with the Anki. We're gonna go over to this one. So slow. Must be encumbered. Do not need rock. Do not need all of these berries either. Alright. Fast forward. Last test. 76 oil on that one. So it must be dependent on the size of the oil rock. Ow. Kill that guy. Thank you. So it looks like you can get more with the Anki, and we were just using different sized rocks. I've never gotten 76 oil with my pick before, so. But it is abundantly, it is way, way slower riding around on this Anki. So I think that one of the strategies we might employ is to go out with one of the Argentavis first and clear that far oil field over there of predators, then drop the Anki down with a Quetzal and gather stuff. But it actually still seems to me like it's faster just to go around with your pick and just harvest all of it and then come back and use a bird to do so. So I'm not sure if we're going to leave this Anki down here or not. We will find out as time goes on. Now let's get back over with the Stegos. All right, so we're back with our Stegos, and I'm weighted down, and the reason why is because I took some time and I made some saddles, because we need some saddles for these. Here we go, Stego saddle for you, and I know what we're going to name them now. I'm going to name them after last season, because I really liked the names that I had. This one is Spike Master Flex. And this one, who needs a saddle as well, we're gonna call Spike Mistress Flo. They're my rapper stegos. Check them out, guys. Spike Master Flex is 106. Not that I'll ever get used for anything. Spike Mistress Flo is only 11. And I also made a saddle for Poop Blaster. And I've got it on me. Apparently, I'm weighted down by some things. Oh, I've got a... Yeah, that's right. So we've got a saddle for him. And I've also got a saddle for Equibian. Equibian also gets a saddle today. So all of my dinos are saddled. Yay! And Equibian's going to stand over here and take care of Poop Blaster. Make sure the Poop Blaster doesn't get in any trouble. So we're going to make sure that Equibian's following Poop Blaster. And I think I've got him on neutral already. Yep, already on neutral. So you take care of Poop Blaster. You take care of him real good. We need to get these stegos over to the base. So we're going to go ahead and put them on follow on Soul on Fire. Right. And Soul on Fire is going to lead them to their new homes. This will be fine over here. So we got a lot accomplished today. We tamed up a Fiomia. We tamed up an Anki. We got a couple of Stegosauruses. We've got a new farm. Things are looking up over at the Black Fortress. We've got a lot more stuff to do. You guys can follow me now. I see that you're going to run into the wall, and that's going to be a problem. And these are going to allow us to have some Argentavis eggs, which I'm really excited about. And when I say that, what I mean is Argentavis kibble. Eggs for Argentavis kibble. All right, you guys can stop following me now. I'm going to put them in the dino garage sometime. They're super slow. All right, so we'll put this one on this side. So we're filling up our dino garage, guys. We're getting some stuff in here. Super exciting. Spike Mistress Flow is going to be even slower. What do we got? Well, I don't know what to do with them. Movement speed. Bump up the movement speed because I want to get them into the garage sometime this century. Right? So Spike Master Flex is in there already. We're going to put Spike Mistress Flow in next to Mammon. Maybe get us some eggs for some Argentavis. Going to be wondrous. Woo! So now, when we come out, we've got some things in here. Look, there's some dinos. I'm going to back her up a little bit. She's a little farther ahead then. OCD's great. Oh, you pooped. Nice. So we've got some stuff in this side. We've got... Where is Pants? Pants, you're not a fighter. I'm going to take you off attack. You're not a fighter. Oh, look. And I think I'm going to up the movement speed on her too. If she's just getting oil doesn't weigh that much. I can drop the rest of the stuff that she picks up. But we're going to put Pants in here. So we're filling the garage up some. Redrick, what are you doing outside? You should be inside. I'm too heavy for you. Okay. So yeah, lots of exciting things happening here today, guys. Pretty stoked. We're going to continue to try to get some tames to fill the garage up with and get our own kibble operation going. But that's going to be it for today's episode. If you liked today's episode, please press the like button. If you haven't already subscribed, please subscribe. If you haven't anything to say, do it in the comments below. And as always, wait for it. Be excellent to each other, folks. Have a great day. See you later.